Welcome here to this very short presentation here on saving files. Saving files is very important. I am presently using the Visualizer 3D Studio Professional Edition version 3.2.1. Okay, in this particular example, saving a file, and this is a very important part because you want to be able to open your data again and to see exactly what it is that you've saved. When we click in here, over here on the icon here, save file, or I could go file and then to save, or the shortcut just by using the button, I'm going to come up with some different options. And the options I have here is scan field overlay. That's an image that we have on over our scan field. We have the soil type, we have transformations, and we have visualizations. To start off at the top, the scan field overlay. This is a default. This is clicked from standard, and the soil type is clicked from standard, the transformations are clicked, and the visualization. These are all standard objects that are saved with the file. The soil type images is not standard, but I'm going to get to that very quickly. Let's start over here with scan field overlay, as I'm going to just simply here, click cancel. I'm going to open up the visualizations tab. I'm going to scroll to the bottom of the tab here. And then in here, we have texture opacity or opacity, depending where you are. You have the scan field overlay. As I move this slider bar to the right, you can see the scan field overlay. As I move it to the left, it is no longer visible. So as we move it here to the middle, you have an idea of where you are. Where is your scan field overlay? Where do I find it? This is in your characteristics tab. Just a real brief here. You can upload under scan field overlay. You can upload an image into here, and this is where your overlay comes from. Then we have the soil type. Soil types are located on the top right corner here. We have the various different soil types. And these soil types are very important because they help to define what kind of soil you're in so that you can have a better or more accurate depth calculation. If you have a particular soil type that you want to save an image of, or it is a custom soil type, on the professional version, when you click Add Soil Type, then you are going to end up with this dialog box where you can put in your particular values and parameters. Under images here, you can upload an image, and this is where your soil type image is going to be. This will be permanently stored in the system, but important that it is also then here collected. At this moment in time, we have our soil type. Let's continue back here. If I want the image here, I have to click, then the image will be saved with. If it is a standard soil and you're just picking it and there is no image extra, you do not need to save it. This will minimize the size of your file. Then we have the transformations. Transformations is simply said, just the view that you are looking at your scan. So if you are looking at it in a 3D area here, you can see, here is a 3D view. And this is what I'm at. I'm either looking at the top view or a side view. There are two different sides, or at a skewed view. So at this moment in time, we're going to return to our top view. And that is your transformations. Then over here are your visualizations. In your visualizations, again here in the visualizations tab, these are different factors. For example, you can change the opacity of your scan overlay. You can change your surface type overlay. Or if you are looking at let's say we're in this perspective view to see the soil as it is given here in this particular image. This will also give here. If this is all at zero and I have here my scan field overlay, then I'm looking at my top view here. And this is your particular options. Going back here to our saving of the file. We have this one folder over here. This folder, Click on that. It says, where do I want to save my file? I can create a new folder. In the new folder, I can put right into this here, create a new folder, or I can put it in the existing folder that there is. And I think this is very important, is once you have a scan and you've made the alterations, give the scan a new name. When it has a new name, then the original data has not been altered. You are saving the file as a new file with a new name. So in the event that you need to go back and access the original data, you can see the original data. Over here, I'm going to click on Select, and then I'm going to click on Save. Once I click on Save, then that dialog box will then be gone. It'll do its business, and you can continue working. That's how we save a file.